I'm going to show you how to make a lower third using the Shape Designer tool in PowerDirector. Let's make a freaking statement, people. I have a video of a gnarly skater doing his damn dizzle in track one, and I want to place a lower third over this guy. I'm going to go ahead and go to the video overlay or PIP object room and left click on that. And then I'm going to go to create a new shape, which will open the shape designer. Now, right now I'm on the rectangle and I'm going to go ahead and leave it on the rectangle. I'm going to resize this by placing my cursor over this node and bring it down. And then I'll go ahead and stretch it out by placing my cursor over this node, holding down my left mouse, dragging it out this way. Then I'll go ahead and place my cursor in the middle or somewhere over it until you see crosshairs. Hold down your left mouse button and then you can drag it into the position that you want. If you don't like this position, you can move it later on. For this, we're going to use a shape preset. So there's plenty of shape presets that you can choose from. I'm going to select this one. I'll left click on it. Now, if you want this preset, but you don't want this color, you can go down to shape fill. You can left click on it. And then you have the option to change the colors. You can use the colors themselves and click on them. You can use eyedroppers, all that stuff. You can change the gradient. You can change it to a uniform color instead of two color gradient, all kind of options on here. Also, if you want to add a outline, you can go ahead and click on shape outline. And then if you click on this caret next to it, there's different options for different types of outlines, sizes, colors, all kind of jazz. I'm going to uncheck that because I don't want the shape outline. Now, the next thing that we're going to do is go ahead and add text. So no one knows what this guy does, so I'm going to type it in. They have no idea he's skateboarding. So you can change the font, you can change the size of the text, you can change the color. All kind of options are available to you for that. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to click on keyframe. And we want to bring this onto the screen like any other lower third. So the first thing that I'm going to do is move my playhead to the position where I want it to be fully on the screen. And that's at about 2 seconds. So I'll just type in 02 and hit enter. It'll take me to the 2 second point on this title that we're creating. Now for the Y position, I want it to be 0.750 and I'll hit enter. And then for the X position, I want it to be 0.350 and I'll hit enter. So now I have it exactly where I want it to be when it comes onto the screen. Now I want to go ahead and create a position keyframe and an opacity keyframe, because those are the two things that I'm going to be changing by bringing it onto the screen and fading it in. So we're going to move our playhead to the beginning all the way down to zero. Then we can change the opacity down to 0%. And that'll make it fade. And then we're going to change the position to move it over to the left and off the screen. So we'll do negative 0.325 and hit enter. And now it's off the screen. So what'll happen is it'll fade in and it'll move to that position that we created. If I scrub the timeline, you'll see it move over and you see it fade onto the screen. So now we'll go ahead and click OK. And it'll ask to give us a name for this template because we're actually creating a custom lower third. And you can use this over and over and over again all you want. So we give it a name. We want to choose a specific keyframe. And I'm going to move it over here to right where everything's on the screen. It lines up with these two keyframes. I know that that's going to be the thumbnail for this. So I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. And now it takes us to the custom room under the PIP or the overlay room. So this is where any saved lower thirds you create in this section are going to show up. And so here you see that the thumbnail is exactly where I put it. So I know which one of the titles it is. And then it gives a preview of what it's going to do when I bring it into the timeline. So now I'm going to go ahead and left click on it, hold down my left mouse, and I'll drag it down to a track that I want. And now if you play this, you'll see the lower third. This lower third is definitely in shape. If you want to add different shapes and symbols to your videos, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my cartoon face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.